We got 15 minutes of hockey left. And this will be a big step forward if we can win this game. A big step forward for this program. Alright, and doing it with underclassmen guys, that's an accomplishment. But we gotta execute and play smart for the next 15 minutes. Can't give up any odd man rushes, can't give away any breakaways, can't leave our hogs hanging out to dry. Good, solid hockey for 15 minutes. Got it, guys? Let's go with this game.
Oh, it's seconds. No, it's a one.
Yeah.
Hey,
all
right, Sam, for you.
Yeah,
stay
away from
the
So without good teammates and good linemates, it wouldn't have been done.
It's a great opportunity, great challenge for us to get our team name out.
Most memorable part of the season, I think, was beating Clifton 5-1 and winning our first ever state game. That was huge for us.
I learned a lot from my brother Tommy, mostly on defense. Tommy showed me what I would do wrong, fix what I would do. Final message I have for Tommy, I just wanted to say thank you for the best 2 years I've had playing hockey. You taught me to be a great leader in the locker room. You taught me all the things I need to know on the ice. And that's going to help me as I'm going on for the next 2 years.
Are you of the
team? I'm extremely proud of this team. There were a couple of games where we were down. West Windsor, Plainsboro North, we were down 3-1. Came back and tied the game. We had great wins against Tarleton Central and Montgomery, teams that I don't think we've beaten Montgomery in all the times that I've been coaching this team. Tarleton Central, we haven't played in a while, but you know, those are two very good teams playing in the Scotland's Conference. I'm very proud of this team, especially being as young as they are and being able to compete in every game and being over 500.
Going into this year, we looked at the schedule. We saw it was a pretty tough schedule. But when me and Katul sat down and talked about it, we said, hey, this is better than playing some of the division teams twice. This is a great opportunity, great challenge for us to get our team name out there. And we saw the team we had and we said, hey, all we gotta do is be patient with these kids, work with them, and we can get the job done, I think.
I was very pleased with our freshman defense pairing. Very difficult to step in and play against guys that are 3 years older than you.
I think they played exceptional this year, considering that freshmen playing, like I said, playing in the against the competition that we were.
Well, we both came in young team, both freshmen, and we were paired up. So we were on the second line, but of course we have a great defenseman and a senior, Tommy Fisher, with his brother Mark, who was doing really good, and Brian held his own. We both did our fair share, I think, and that resulted in decent defense from two freshmen.
I thought they held their own physically, mentally. They were smart players. I look forward to having them together for the next 3 years. They did a great job.
It was one of my concerns going into the season, how we're going to be defensive. We had two freshmen paired up with each other, and I think they played exceptional, and I'm looking for good things out of them going forward.
We ended up having a winning season, and our freshmen really played hard and surprised a lot of people, honestly.
Next year is definitely going to be a challenge for us. We certainly lose a lot in both Tommy Fisher and Katul Patel. They really brought a lot of points to the team and a lot of leadership.
Well, seniors are important on any team. Usually you look to seniors for leadership first. Oftentimes they are your captains or assistant captains, and in this case that was true.
It's going to be tough to replace them. I don't think you can. And I don't know, we just gotta overcome the challenge.
Losing seniors is important, But from a numbers standpoint this year, we're only losing two. And while it's sad to lose seniors, they certainly are going, and you can't replace them either, but there's only two of them. Whereas in years past, for example, the prior year, we lost 10 seniors. And that leaves a very large hole in the middle of your team. So hopefully, the younger kids can rise up to fill those holes a little easier.
Well, to lose Tommy Fisher and Ketul Patel is going to be difficult. They're two exceptional players. Losing Tommy is on the ice, it's hard to replace a player like him. But it's not just what Tommy brings on the ice, it's what Tommy brings into the locker room and off the ice. You very rarely see Tommy get excited, and he's a very calming factor. So from that perspective, you know, it's going to be difficult to replace Ketul. You know, he's big on the ice. He's, you know, he's over 6 feet tall. We don't have a big team, so losing Ketul at the forward line, where we don't have size, it's going to be tough to replace. Going forward, obviously, we're going to be without them, so we need to figure out who's going to step up and take those roles. And but it's going to be tough. It's not going to be an easy task replacing those two players. The Morris Knowles game, you know, I went over to two of them, and I thanked them both for playing this year, and that's, you know, probably one of the most memorable things. Having Tommy and Ketul come back as seniors, looking at the schedule, we're playing some of the toughest teams in the state with 15 underclassmen. It could have been very easy for the two of them to look back, look at the schedule, look at the team, and go, you know what, why play the season out? You know, or they could have looked at it and said, you know what, we're not going to win, so I'm just going to look to put as many goals in as I can. And they didn't do that. You know, they played as a team. They worked with the team. They tried to mentor the younger players when they could. So after the Morris Knowles game, we took a good, you know, big loss there. I went over to the two of them, and I thanked them both for playing the 4 years, but especially for sticking it out this year and working with the team and working with the younger players. So that was probably the most memorable thing to me.
Oh, it was a pleasure playing with both of you again, to watch Tommy play on D and Ketul with his great offensive skill. Pleasure to watch and play with. So I wish both of them luck wherever they go. And just wanted to say thanks for helping me out as a freshman and giving me pointers here and there coming into high school hockey.
I wouldn't consider myself a vocal leader, especially in the locker room. What I do, I lead by example. Every shift on the ice, I try and be noticed. That is my goal, and I hope everybody notices me. That's how I lead, by example. This year, more than ever though, I did start to be a little more vocal on the ice. As the game was going on, I would bark orders at all the kids.
And it's going to be tough to bring that back to another young squad. And we'll see. You know, I'm excited for it, and I'd like to see how we can overcome the challenges like we did this year.
Well, you know, as far as the guys that are leaving, it's been a pleasure. We've had a lot of different experiences with each other, some highs and some lows, and then, you know, you're gonna remember both of them. High school sports is something that you can bring with you forever, no matter what you do. I can remember my time in high school like it was yesterday. And, you know, they did a great job leading this team of transition, because really this was a huge transition year for us.
How big of a change was it?
Oh, it was an exceptional change. I mean, it was unbelievable the way that the team improved end to end.
This team, as the year went on, I just think they understood what it took to compete against older players. We moved the puck so much better at the end of the year than we did at the beginning of the year. As we played stronger competition, we would rise to that level. So I was very pleased with the progression of this team. It certainly is going to have to continue to improve in order for us to be a successful program.
That was just an unbelievable turnaround in the way the team played, moving the puck, as well as confidence. The team, you can just see with every game that we won, the players, especially the freshmen, got more and more confident with their abilities, playing against the seniors on the other team. So that was a big difference.
Name a player or two that stepped up the most or unexpectedly when asked to at any point.
Well, let me start with the freshmen. Because it was all unexpected to me, I didn't know any of them.
Oh, offensively, Tyler. He was able to come off freshman year. When I was freshman, not a lot of kids played. This kid just came out, did his job, always warmed up before the games, and I definitely love playing with him, both in travel and sometimes when I play with him in high school. He's a great player to have.
I thought that Tyler Allen gave us an awful lot of speed. A kid that wound up being a first-line forward for us. As a freshman, he's got an extraordinarily bright future. Again, I'll revert back to our freshman defense pairing. They played really smart hockey. And as they grow and get physically stronger and more intelligent in the game, I think we're going to have a real shutdown blue line pairing there.
Matt Krasinski's junior goalie, his confidence grew also. He saw a lot of pucks. He played a lot of games where, unfortunately, we got outshot 2-1, 3-1, 4-1. But I think he's going to be, we're looking forward to him doing good things for us. And we're going to need him to be a contributor if we're going to compete.
As far as Mark and Tommy go, I know that Mark really values Tommy's opinion. Tommy's a very good teacher of the game.
Hopefully, Mark learned from his brother and be one of a handful of juniors. So we're going to expect him to step up and play with confidence.
However, I also think it might benefit Mark to not have Tommy there. Tommy's a very, very good player. And sometimes it's difficult to perform next to a sibling that's that strong. So I think Mark's really going to come into his own and be a much more confident player when he's the last fisher in the program.
Jeffrey Wu, there's not a whole lot you can say about Jeffrey. He's tenacious. He carries the puck well, he makes the pass, he's probably one of the most talented players we've got on the team, but he's also probably one of the most unselfish players we have on the team, and that's a good combination to have. Brian Mazur, a defenseman, freshman, had a little concerned about Brian early in the season, especially after we played Old Bridge. In Old Bridge, he took a pretty good hit, was worried about his confidence level. I know he got injured in that game, but I think his confidence built after that.
The fact that they were able to hold down the blue line, at that age, allowed us to be a little more aggressive, with our forward lines.
And Brian Mason, they hold their ground pretty well. I think they'll definitely be big parts next year and going to GMCs.
As far as the guys coming back, they can have whatever they want. They can set the bar wherever they want to and achieve it. That's not always true. Sometimes you're limited as to what your talent level is or what your ability or your capabilities are. And I don't think that's true with this team.
Hunter Rule, he's not big in stature, but I know he likes to go out and hit, which I wish some of the bigger players on the team would take that away. I'm looking forward to having Hunter back on the team next year as a junior. And he's got that feisty mentality. He's not afraid to go into the corner. So he's going to be a fun player to watch, especially as he matures.
But they're going to have to realize that it's going to take hours of being uncomfortable and pushing yourself to get there. So, I hope that they do, because this could be a great experience for them when they look back on it in 5, 6, 7 years.
What are the expectations for next year's team?
My expectations for next year are pretty high. My expectation is to be a top 10 team in the Public A. I like to be in the top 20 overall. I have a lot of expectations. If everybody returns as I expect they will, I think this is a team that can compete at the highest of levels. I honestly think we can compete against St. Joe's next year, against the GMCs. I know they worry about us every year. We knocked them out the first year for the GMCs, and they know that they don't like playing us.
Sure. Certainly the success of this year, and I think it was a successful season, is going to make us set the bar much higher for next year. We will still be very young. We'll be a very young team next year, but the kids have shown us what they can do, so now we're going to expect that out of them, and we're going to expect that they get in the weight room. They do the work off the ice to make them more confident on the ice. To me, that's the biggest issue that we're going to have, and we're going to have to improve on our strengths. Our strengths are speed and moving the puck, so we're going to have to hold every pass and move tape to tape and make sure that we are outworking teams. And if we do that, I foresee a very bright future.
Overall, how proud are you of your team?
Very proud of what they accomplished. Had you asked me before the season if I would have taken a 500 record, I'd have been yes and thrilled. As it turns out, we wound up a game over 500. And you know, when you're in the midst of it, though, you forget what your expectations were. You know, I expected, once we were playing well, to defeat everyone. You know, that didn't work out for us, but we played some very, very good teams this year, and we competed with all of them. When I look back on it, I look at it as a very, very successful season, but one where we still left some things out on the table. Hopefully the kids will learn that every game is very important, because our loss to Monroe really wound up costing us when it came to seeding. They need to continue to improve, you know, to get to the level of the Morris Knowles that we saw. If they really want to remember this high school experience, they don't want to think, yeah, I was a four-year varsity player, but we never really won anything. So hopefully we can continue to push them and make their experience even better.